at least it's somewhat entertaining. The Suicide Squad is the divisive sequel to the 2016 disaster so bad it reduced David Ayer to second-grade arguments. It's awful, David. Nuh-uh. This time, written and directed by James Gunn, a new team is assembled for a mission in Corto Maltese to destroy a secret lab called Jotunheim. The mission immediately goes tits up, half the cast cashes in their checks, and we are left with a team scrambling to complete a mission like a multiplayer co-op game with all the wanton death and destruction that comes along with it. The main question now is, did James Gunn make the bestest ever comic book movie, or is all the hype overstated? Let's jump into this. There's a lot of give and take throughout the film. For starters, the screenplay isn't bad. Numerous setups lead to payoffs, whether they are small bullets or glaring, like this big metal toothpick that couldn't possibly be used against the giant one-eyed McWheaton javelins we saw in the trailers. It is also nice to see a kaiju as the ultimate villain of a comic book movie for once, so the change of pace is welcome, and Starro will always be memorable, unlike half of the MCU's roster, even tossing in a line that sort of makes you feel bad for Starro. It isn't the only character the gun handles sort of well here. King Shark is given the Groot treatment and made out to be like George of Mice and Men. Most of the remaining cast, like Ratcatcher 2, Bloodsport, and Polka Dot Man, are all introduced, and while they have little in the way of backstory, they at least are given some, unlike the previous Suicide Squad. The same can't be said for the rest. Harley Quinn has absolutely nothing to do here. All she does is ruin jokes with her incessant chatter, making me want to drill out both of my eardrums. You could completely remove Harley, and it would have been a net positive for the film. Besides her, there are numerous people here for a paycheck that could solve world hunger and offer nothing for the film. I get why Pete Davidson is here, to satisfy me with what may never come to him, but why on earth is Peter Capaldi here? How about Michael Rooker? He's a tough badass, calling the team a bunch of rookies. Oh, look at that, he panics, runs away, and loses his head. Maybe that would have been funny if it wasn't telegraphed from a mile away with smoke signals. This brings to light that much of the humor is hit or miss. Gunn's writing has been up and down throughout his career, and this film is no different. First and foremost, John Cena is funny, receiving the Drax treatment here like James Cameron could get out of Arnold from Terminator to True Lies. The scene where Cena is standing there in nothing but tighty-whities had me chuckling the whole way through. However, this can't be said of the jokes that should have ended after the punchline. Many drag on like a kid told to clean the room. The camp scene is the best example. The squad is to rescue Flag, who is believed to be a prisoner. The team systematically butchers their way through the camp, eating people, setting them on fire, and handing out divorce papers. People are screaming, exploding, and crying as they get massacred with all the efficiency of a goat in a hot dog eating contest. After 5 minutes, the squad reaches Flag only to realize they just slaughtered 90% of the resistance fighters. Okay, but why was no one alerted? There were people literally watching this happen and they didn't do anything until it was their cue? Why? How did Flag not hear the massacre? This is not the only example of questionable humor that runs on longer than an ultra marathon. God, even the Melvin joke is ruined by Harley, who decided to open her fucking mouth and repeat the whole joke again. It isn't just these actions, but the idiotic inactions that set up these forced situations. King Shark almost eats Ratcatcher too. So did no one check to see if he would endanger such a high priority mission? Blackguard contacted the Corto Maltese government, but if Waller always has visual and or audio connection with those she sends out, she should have known he contacted them. Also, Waller loses contact with the team once they are in the city, but if that's the case, then how did she lose contact with Flag in the jungle? Waller could have just told the squad that Flag was in a resistance camp and wants to use them to help achieve the objective. So why not inform the squad? Why? All these questions and many more go unanswered like Jimmy Hoffa's whereabouts. I said earlier, there is give and take throughout the film, but the negatives are overwhelming like doom scrolling on Twitter. The Suicide Squad is really bad. It is better than its predecessor, but still not a movie I would ever want to waste my time on again. And if given the option, I would rather French kiss an angle grinder. Now, thanks for watching. Please, like, share, ring the bell for notifications, and if you want to watch more movie reviews, check out my review of M. Night Shyamalan's most recent mess, Old, over there. And I'll see you in the next video.